Hello, this is BKRY Media, and today we are interviewing artist and producer AyoAlexis. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
My name is AyoAlexis, 19 years old, like he said. I'm an artist producer. I also engineer my own stuff. Been making music for 4 years now.
True force to be reckoned with and an upcoming artist in the city. Let's start the interview and get to know him and his process when it comes to making music. First question, where are you from?
Okay, so this gets a little bit tricky if I'm being honest. I was just telling him earlier. So I had originally grew up until I was about 4 in Logan Square, and then my parents thought it would be a good idea for me to get my education. So we moved right before I was going to go to kindergarten to a town called Des Plaines, and I lived there right about until COVID, and that's when we got lucky and found a house back in the city. It was a long journey. I'm very glad, we got through it, and I'm not going to say where I'm from, well, where I'm at right now, because I don't want to, douse myself.
So, how does living and growing up in that area affect you creative?
The one thing I can say was that I felt like in these plans there was a lot of push for music in general. Like my high school, they offered a bunch of different programs. I was in a band before that, and when I got to high school, I was in marching band. So I got to learn a lot about the foundations of music, reading sheet music, practicing with the ensemble and everything. And then I also had choir class, which helped me out a lot with my confidence when it came to singing. I remember when I first started rapping. I imagine this happens to a lot of people where you don't feel as confident in your voice,
Yeah, you keep going. That's the song of the city.
I'm just very grateful for that.
Gotcha. So what sparked the vision to begin making?
I remember it like it was yesterday. So, growing up, I listened to a lot of different kind of music, and in around middle school, I learned about fast rap. So I would always try to practice different rap verses, like rap battles. This one I tried doing, and at lunch, I would always just perform for my friends. And then one day, I'm just rapping, and I forgot what it was called, but it's basically like the class where you go to learn how to cook, culinary and stuff. No, it's not culinary. It's like a...
Oh, it's like home ec?
Yeah, home ec. And one of my classmates, shout out Scripps, he's a photographer. Him and my teacher were both like, "You should do the talent show." And I'm like, why not? So, I fell in love with performing.
You got a video of that?
I probably do. I would have to ask my parents, but
I need the video.
I want the origin video. But I fell in love with just performing on the stage, and then it wasn't really until freshman year of high school where people were like, "You should make your own music." And I'm like, "You're right." So I just tried it out and been doing it ever since.
So is there anyone or anything you draw inspiration from?
Definitely my family, just because we're all hard work
people to do that.
So. Yeah. That's the one thing I'm very grateful about, is that my parents were actually supportive of it. My dad was basically the reason why I got my home studio. Sabo, shout out Noah, shout out Ken, and shout out to anybody who came before me too. Just surrounding myself with other people who want to create has definitely helped out a lot. And I mean, of course, artists that we listen to.
So I want to move on to your journey as an artist. Mm-hmm. You mentioned like band and like the music at school and stuff. But let's get to a little more mind. So stuck in my head, how was the experience of making that project?
Definitely a roller coaster of emotion. I remember, the time it stuck in my head, like it was just a bunch of thoughts that I was having at the time. I was just trying to explore myself creatively, and I was just going through a sort of a rough time, like just me finding myself, but also like feeling distant from everybody, since that's when I had like first moved away. And so to give y'all like a sort of feel about it, imagine you, like incoming freshman, going from high school to college. I feel like I had to do that jump halfway through my high school year. So it like felt weird. I like felt very distant. And so that's mainly what I grabbed about, I really just used it as a way to express myself.
You can definitely hear that in some of the songs. Mm-hmm. So, we have a music video coming soon, we're working on.
Yeah.
Go ahead and say the title.
The song is called Why, and I'm gonna have Sabo on this, SUK. It's gonna be crazy.
So what is the story behind your verse and your part in the song, Why?
This is gonna sound like a little, but I sort of never really had best of luck when it came to girls and stuff. And so, when I was rapping, I've been on my A game, so I just let it be. Like that's a song. That's a song. That's a lyric from the song, it's kind of like just me doing my own thing, because I know the girl who I might want to pursue or might be talking to isn't really gonna benefit me that much. So just going through the motions of that, basically.
So more backstory, you and S3K. So how did you guys meet?
Funny enough, him and I were talking about that not too long ago. So it was on the set of my first ever music video I ever recorded, which was with 180 Mindset, Good for the Soul. It was our second day of shooting, and we needed somebody with a speaker. And Ken was like, "Oh, yo, I can invite Sabo." I'm like, "Okay, cool." And comes through, and I mean, everything was chill. It was cool getting to know him. And I honestly don't remember how exactly it happened after that. Basically, him and I just started talking more and more, and it became cool.
So, what's next? Is there anything coming soon, or is there anything we should expect soon?
Well, first of all, music video, when we get to work on that. I have a lot of unreleased music that I've been experimenting with. It's more melodic stuff, because I feel like for a good portion of my early period, at least, I really wanted to do a lot more melodic sort of things. So, a little more auto-tune heavy. That don't mean I can't sing, though. And,
bust out the choirs here.
Especially with the acoustics in this room. But, I'm trying to work on the project, trying to make things work.
Do we get a title? Or no? We gotta wait.
I'm still figuring that out.
That's pretty fully transparent. So, what's your goal when making music?
I feel like ever since I was younger, you know, I've always struggled with like feeling like I belong to a community, and I know that can be a little bit tough, you know, because you feel like you're alone. So that's definitely one of my goals, you know, just having a fan base or like a community where y'all feel like you can talk with each other, grow with each other. Also, trying my best to say a positive message. You know, a lot of the songs nowadays, not saying that they give off a bad message, but it's like repetitive. I wouldn't say it's repetitive. It's more like chill music.
You know? Oh, yeah, it's listen to like, yeah, you don't need the process. Mm-hmm.
Like, so I want to see if I can put my own twist on it and still put a message while making it sort of like that chill or like stuff that I can just sort of play in the background.
The way you worded it, I didn't know where you
were going. Dude, yeah, that's what I was trying to be careful to.
But definitely. So I thank you for this conversation and lending me your time. It's been a great conversation. Appreciate you. I have one more question for you before we end this. Who is AyoAlexis to you?
AyoAlexis is, you know, the best disciplined version of myself. Guy who's outgoing. Kind to the people he meets, a guy who's not as afraid to express himself, you know, especially creatively.
I'm missing that. You're good. In the magazine, I'll fix it.
And that's just overall. Just someone who you can have a good time with.
Well, there you go. There you have it. Go ahead and tell the people where to find you on your music.
You can find me. You can find me on Instagram, AyoAlexis, and underscore. After that, on all music platforms, including YouTube, it's just AyoAlexis altogether.
YouTube, Spotify,
Apple Music, SoundCloud,
Tidal. Damn.
I think whatever this show kid gives you. Hey.
And, yeah, appreciate you for having me.
Thank you. First interview too, so it's kind of crazy. Dang.
Exclusive. But we've been BKRY Media with AyoAlexis. We out.